How do you get me now? Welcome to our anointing service. Thank you so much, sir. Loud and clear. I'm happy. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm happy to be here today in the name of Jesus. Good evening. Welcome to our anointing service. You're welcome. And today I want to assure you, you are not going back the same way you came, in Jesus' name. It has echo. Can you hear me? Libada. Yes, I understand. I think it's because of the room, but I know God is faithful in the name of Jesus Christ. Is it clear? Good evening. I want to hear if you can hear me loud and clear in the name of Jesus. Libada zeke yatalaba zoko yatalaba zoko yala. Libada zoko yatalaba. Welcome to our anointing service. I want you to welcome and to tell a friend, share a friend, share with a friend in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm so excited to be here today. I'm looking forward. It's my day to be delivered. It's my day for every yoke to be broken in Jesus' name. Welcome Susie Kadenge. Welcome Martha. Welcome Jackie. Welcome Lorraine. Welcome Judy. Welcome Lillian. I'm so excited to see you. I'm so excited that you can hear me. I've been looking forward for this day, and God has been faithful. God has been so faithful, and we are here today. Hey, Libada Yakatalaba. Hello, hello, Lillian. I love you so much, everybody. Come in, come on, call your friend, tell a friend, share with a friend. Maybe someone has just forgotten their time, but I know God is faithful. It's our season in the name of Jesus. Libada Zeke Yatalaba Zoku Hata. Liprosuka Yatalaba. Manda laba zeke yata laba zonda. Liga da zeke yata laba zika talaba. Liba da zeke yanda laba zonda. Lipo suka. Can you hear me? Lipa hata laba zoko yanda. Legede zika yata laba zoko yanda. Manda laba zoko yata laba zika yata. Liba da zeke yata laba zika yanda. Lipo suka yata laba zeke yanda. I'm live and I'm listening and I'm watching you. Lipa hata laba zeke yanda. Is the echo still on? Can someone hear me? Is the echo too much? Can you hear me now? Liba da zeke yata laba zoko yata laba zende. Lipa suka yanda. Today is your day that every yoke is being broken in the name of Jesus. As we began, and like we said last Wednesday, that today was going to be our anointing service in the name of Jesus. Mandalaba zeke yatalaba. Thank you so much. Now it's clear. Thank you. Thank you so much. God bless you, everybody. I'm so happy. You're one in a million. I love you. I love you so much. Libada zeke yatalaba zoko yanda. God is faithful. I want you to type and say, it's my season. Every yoke is being broken tonight. Every yoke is being broken in the name of Jesus. As you share it with your friend, tell someone to tell a friend, share it with someone, share in the name of Jesus. Libada zaka yata. Today is our season of breakthrough. Today is our season of turnaround in the name of Jesus. I'm so excited because I know it's my season for breakthrough, and so is your season. This message is not just for you, it's also my season. And the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 10 and verses 27, the Bible says, in that day their burden shall be, or will be lifted from off their shoulder.
from off their shoulder. The burden will be lifted from off. In other words, the heavy load, the baggage that has been on your head, the baggage from your home that has been withholding you, the baggage of your destiny that was to be a blessing and now is a baggage, shall be lifted, shall be lifted. Burden is a baggage, shall be lifted off your shoulder. And the scripture continues to say what? Their yoke from your neck. Their yoke from your neck. Meaning, yoke is a symbol, is something that holds. It's like, it's what most people understand. Those who do a lot of farming with cattle, they understand. Is what is used that is tied. It's like a bond servant. You are a bond servant. It's used to plow. So the Bible says that yoke, whatever has yoked itself with your destiny, today is coming to be destroyed. Today is being destroyed with the anointing of God. And the Bible continues to say the yoke will be broken. So today, every yoke of limitation, every yoke of backwardness, I'm sent to tell you in the name of Jesus, they must let you go. I'm here to tell you that the anointing of God is here to break every stagnation. The anointing in the name of Jesus. Share with a friend, tell someone as we begin in the name of Jesus. Today is our anointing service in the name of Jesus. Every yoke must let you go in the name of Jesus, child of God. I'm here to tell you what the devil meant for evil. God permitted it so that it can receive the power of the anointing. The power of the anointing. Anytime I hear and I see about the anointing, anointing. Why? What is anointing and why the anointing service? What does it signify? Anointing signifies what was the work that was finished on the cross. It signifies what Jesus did. The power of the anointing. What he did at the cross. And that's why we are called the righteousness of Christ. What he went through. The bondage, the accusation, the pressure, the doubts that people had about our Lord Jesus Christ was all finished at the cross. And the anointing oil represents is a sacred service, or let me say activity. It's not just an activity, it's a sacred session that the Lord allows to separate or to sanctify. So when we stop that today is our anointing service. The Lord last Sunday was speaking to me about it, but I was a bit hesitant as a child of God because I wanted to be sure, Daddy, is this you? But I thank God for him to confirm that indeed today is meant and was meant to be our anointing service. So today, anything that is not of God, that has been withholding you, that has been tying you down, it's coming to an end in Jesus' name, because the power of the anointing of God is here to break every yoke, is here to break every limitation in the name of Jesus Christ. A yoke is something that represents captivity, slavery, but today something that is fastened, that anywhere you go, I must go with you. If it is your season for breakthrough and you're about to receive it, that yoke will display itself before your destiny helpers, and then you wonder what's the issue. But the Bible says that it shall come that day that the yoke, and in that day the yoke shall be broken, that their burden will be lifted, and not only be lifted, off their shoulder, and their yoke shall be broken. How shall they be broken? With the power of the anointing. So today, every spirit of stagnation, every spirit of nearness to success syndrome, the anointing of God is going to break that yoke in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Bayata Lava Zakahata Manda Lava Zokota Lava, today is your day. Those demons that have been refusing you to go, they must let you go in the name of Jesus. They must let you go in the name of Jesus. Lipo sika yatalaba, liba da zeke yanda, lika yata. The anointing signifies what the Lord did at the cross, the Lord Jesus Christ. It lies to what he did, the finished work at the cross. For today we are here to break that which the kingdom of darkness has been putting on your shoulder, that which the foundations from your home has been fighting you. And child of God, you remember last week we were talking about the Amalekite. right. So the anointing of God today is breaking what we were talking about last week, and today, in the name of Jesus, today is the crown, the day of it, in the name of Jesus, that after that service, today is our service of anointing service. So I want you to get an anointing oil. I told people to do so in the name of Jesus, and in case you did not know, I will instruct you what to do in the name of Jesus Christ as per the leading of the Holy Spirit. Today is your season for turnaround. Tell a friend to tell a friend, I want you to share in the name of Jesus. There is nothing that God cannot do in the name of Jesus Christ. Liba da zeke ya talaba, maka ya talaba zonda, legede zika ya talaba, lekro talaba zende, maka ya talaba zende, lipro soko talaba. Where do we get the anointing oil? What is this that people are saying anointing oil? The anointing oil we talk about is about a specific oil that has been set apart to be used by priests to anoint, to consecrate, to separate. God ordained it like that. And we get the anointing oil from the olive fruit. This olive fruit, before you get that oil, you must crush the anointing, you must crush that seed. That fruit must be crushed. The moment it has been crushed, there will be something coming out of it. Whatever is coming out, and it goes into three sets. So when we talk about the anointing oil, for you to receive that anointing oil, we get it from a fruit, olive fruit. And this olive fruit, it's not like every other fruit. First of all, it has to be crushed. And today, as we are speaking about the anointing and being our anointing service, I want to let you know, when the Bible talks about the yoke shall be broken by the power of the anointing. By the power of the anointing. Number one, you need to realize one thing. The anointing, before we get it, it has to be crushed. In other words, someone you are watching me today, what does it signify in our day-to-day life and in our service today? Whatever has been destroying you, today the anointing of God is going to crush it. And after crushing it, because the moment it's being crushed, the moment they are done with crushing it, we receive olive oil in it. The first, it gives first the extra virgin oil. And the moment it comes out, it most of the time, that is what is used in the Jewish temple to lighten. So number one step that you need to know, that the anointing of God today is breaking every yoke of stagnation, is crushing down every spirit of limitation, is coming to enlighten your destiny. Because the first step, because there are three steps that the olive oil, olive fruit goes through for it to extract three types of oil. And when we look at it, I began by saying, it signifies what the Lord did on the cross. Now the first step, which is the crushing of it, and the moment it is crushed, we extract or we find out of it olive oil, extra virgin oil, and it's used in the Jewish temple to do what? To lighten the lamps inside. And remember last week, I said, based on what the Spirit of God was revealing to us, the scripture says in the book of Proverbs 20:27 that we are the candlelight of the Lord. In other words, the Lord uses us. So until you are crushed, you will never understand. So the Lord allowed you to be crushed for you to be anointed, to receive that virgin extra oil. So today, when we talk about Jesus Christ, the first thing, it also represents the first three steps that Jesus went through at the Garden of Gethsemane. Gethsemane means it simply means the olive place, olive press. So that place, number one, the process that he went through was the deliverance. Deliverance of what? Deliverance from powers of darkness. So the moment it crashed the first step, and we extract from it the extra virgin oil, that virgin oil is used to lighten the lamps in the Jewish temple. So today, you are not only going to be anointed. Today, you are going to receive your first step of breakthrough. Your every darkness that has been covering your destiny, that anytime you appear before your destiny helper, they don't see you, but they see other people. That darkness, the veil of darkness is being broken. That garment of darkness that they have given you, that when you appear, nothing is popping out. And the scripture tells us that you are the candlelight of the Lord, and the Lord uses you to speak to the rest. Today is being broken in the name of Jesus. Lebo da zeke ya talaba. Maka talaba zende. Legede zika ya talaba zende. Liba da zeke ya talaba. Lipo suka ya talaba zende. When you read the book of Luke 22:53, you realize that when they came to arrest Jesus at Gethsemane, he told them, that is what you've been honoring. Today, let it honor you, because this is what you wanted. Just the same way when I look at people tonight, you've been going through a lot. The Amalekites dealt with you, and you've come to a point you can't understand. Today is our anointing service. That which has been an issue, as you're listening to me, I want you to be typing your prayer request, because today we are going to pray that after the last week's service, and today is the anointing service, every Amalekite, every yoke that has been holding you, that has been making you to be its bond servant, today the yoke is being broken and you are receiving your freedom in Jesus' name. Every yoke that has said they will never leave you, today they must leave you. The chains they have put on your neck and the burden on your shoulder, with the power of God tonight, is being lifted. The scripture tells me in the book of Isaiah chapter 61 verses 1, the Lord has anointed me to proclaim, to set free the captive. Every bondage that the kingdom of darkness has tied you, I am here today to break it in the name of Jesus. I speak the name. Let the name of the Lord, every yoke must be broken. The yoke of delay, the yoke of nearness to success syndrome. What do I mean that by nearness to success syndrome? When you're about to receive your breakthrough, people will clap for you. Others will even make clothes to celebrate you. But before you know it, they say, oh, my sister, I'm sorry. This time round, no. I am here to tell you, this is what the Lord is going to do. With the anointing of God upon my life, and that battle that you are holding, it ceases to be normal bottle. It ceases to be normal bottle. But the anointing inside it, the bottle is just the container. But whatever is inside, it represents the power of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Libada Zekeyata, the second press of the olive oil, the second press of the olive fruit, after extracting the virgin oil from it that is being used in the temple to light, just the same way, if your body has been having infirmity, the second press is for healing, is medicinal. So this second healing, this medicinal, I want you to know that from the service of today, every spirit of sicknesses, bondage that has been holding you, I'm not just meaning about your body, I'm also meaning about your family. Your finances might have been sick. You might be sick emotionally, materially. You've got nothing to represent. But the second press of the olive fruit, it brings out a certain kind of oil. That oil brings what? Brings healing. It's medicinal. So it brings out a recipe that brings healing and makes you whole. Just the same way in 22:43, when Jesus was in agony, when they got him, praise the living God, when they got him, he was delivered from pain. Number one, the first step of the virgin oil when the fruit is being pressed, don't forget, the olive fruit, what we get is the virgin oil that is used to candlelight. The second thing, and that represents what Jesus did, he was delivered from power of darkness. And the second thing that we are talking, the second press of the olive oil, is now talking about the extraction that brings the olive, that is medicinal, that is used for healing. So today, as Jesus did it, that represents the agony he went through and he was healed. So tonight, that God is going to set you free from every unhealthy health that you are going through, anything that is making you to become the deceased. Let me tell you the truth, you are being delivered in Jesus' name. That disease that has kept you captive, that before you sleep, you must swallow 10 drugs for you to sleep. Today is your season for healing. It's your hour for healing. In the name of Jesus, I want you to grab and say it's your season for healing. In the name of Jesus Christ, today is our anointing service. And today the anointing of God is in three categories. Healing you totally. And not only in categories. All around you are receiving your healing. In the name of Jesus Christ. The third press of the olive oil. That olive oil, the third press of it from the fruit. Olive fruit is used for making soap or for cleansing. What does it mean? The Lord will cleanse you. Number three, the third thing represents what he did. That's why I began by saying the anointing. It, when we talk of the anointing oil, what the significance of it all, it represents or lies in what Jesus did at the cross, the finished work on the cross. And the moment it was done so, we received our liberty. We see the freedom that the disciples received. Instant, they began speaking in tongues, and they were able to understand one another. They were speaking in different language, meaning there was oneness. If you're watching me and in your family, there is war. Tonight is your night of deliverance. The anointing of God tonight that he has bestowed over my life is, as I release it, I believe you are receiving your healing in Jesus' name. The Lord saw what you went through, and that's why he put this message for you. Maybe you're watching me in the hospital. Maybe you're in your home. You don't have what to eat. You feel as if God has left you. Today, the anointing of breaking every yoke, every chain is being broken, because he has anointed me to do what? To set the captive free. That is why on the third press, when we are talking about the anointing, the olive oil that cleanses, that produces the soap, that is finally what he did at the cross. He died on the cross and he said, it is finished. So it is not, what is a yoke? A yoke is bondage. Living in slavery, and that is what the kingdom of darkness has been doing. But I'm here to tell you, no more bondage in your life, in the name of Jesus. You shall not struggle, in the name of Jesus Christ. When Jesus did it at the cross, he said, it is finished. And he said, he told his disciples in John chapter 14, and the spirit of truth shall come upon you, and the yoke also shall be broken. When the scripture talks of that, imagine the two scriptures. When the spirit of truth comes upon you, in other words, there is an enlightenment. So what does it mean? When the anointing of God comes upon you, speed is inevitable. Speed is inevitable. When someone gives a pit for you to enter, do you know what happens? That pit they dug for you, you jump and pass. And you still remain alive in the name of Jesus. Tonight, the anointing that you are receiving today is the anointing of Jabez Pass, is the anointing of breaking every yoke in the name of Jesus. The Amalekites that you've been seeing, the Amalekites that have been feeding you wrong information, today is your day of deliverance. I am here to speak deliverance. I am here to set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jeremiah 15, he says, I will deliver them from their enemies. Not only will he do that, he says, and I will redeem them in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive your deliverance. So today I am here to break every yoke. Every yoke that has been holding you. A yoke is a symbol of slavery. A yoke is a symbol of stagnation. A yoke is a symbol of nearness to success syndrome. That anywhere you go, it's just like the surname you carry. That when you speak or when someone hears your surname, they say no. Why? It's because what is pertaining to that name, the spirit behind it, that is what today God is going to do. He's breaking that Amalekite. He's breaking those yokes. In the name of Jesus, Manda Lava Zekeyata, Negede Zikayata, Makata Lava Zende, Nigede Zikayata. So, child of God, I want you to know there's one thing you need to realize. The moment he died on the cross, he said, it is finished. That we no longer needed to start pleading, to go to people and plead on behalf of us. No, the moment he said, it is finished. We speak to him through his spirit, the spirit of truth, the spirit of love, the spirit of might. And that is the spirit today. By the reason of the anointing tonight, every yoke is being broken. Every arrow of stagnation is being defeated. In the name of Jesus Christ, every yoke must let you go. The moment the anointing of God comes upon you, like it came upon Jesus, through the process, the crushing press is never easy, child of God. The crushing moment is as if you are forgotten. The crushing moment is as if you are alone. The crushing moment you can be mistaken. On the crushing moment you can be called names. On the crushing moment you might feel as if the Lord has left you. But see, Jesus went through the agony because Jesus knew what by the end of the day we are going to receive. He did not give up. Now you want to give up. Now that you want to give up, there are people's lives that will end because you're giving up. No, child of God, you don't have to give up. Stand up and fight that war in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, the anointing that is coming upon you is the anointing of favor all around. It's the anointing of touch not. It's the anointing of jump and pass. What do I mean by jump and pass? Any pit they dug for you, when the anointing of God comes upon you, you become a touch not. What they speak against you cannot stand. God will cause people to defend you, even in your absentia. But right now, anytime you make anything with someone or anybody, when you know you're going to receive it, before you know it, things backfire. From today, that yoke is being broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, that is why I'm here tonight. We spoke about the Amalekites. Today, they must let you go. In this anointing service today, I want you to know your life is being transformed. Maybe we've not had an opportunity to share about the testimonies, but if we begin telling you the testimonies that people are receiving, you'll be shocked. But nevertheless, you are the next one. I receive a call from you to testify. You will tell me of a testimony. You will tell me of that home. You will tell me of that breakthrough that the Lord has done in Jesus' name. This is a, never forget that this is a September for you to remember. This is the last third quarter of three quarter of 2020. I decree, and in the month of September, I decree and I declare, no weapon fought against you shall prosper. Any tongue that will rise against you, the Lord shall condemn. Tonight, every yoke must let you go. Yoke of premature death. I hear limitations are being broken. Kagendo, I hear favor. Kagendo, I hear favor. In the name of Jesus Christ. Manda labazeke yata. Makuta labazende. Lege de zika yata. I hear the masses of God all over you. Lege de kagendo. I hear the mercy of God. Kagendo, I hear God serving, said, delivering you from what you thought it was all over again. I see your name being showcased to people that you never thought they would have seen you. Hey, Libada, today is our anointing service, and the anointing will break every spirit of delay. You are not only going to receive the spirit of might, but you're receiving strength, persistent grace, persistent mercy. God is going to release speed that no man will take glory. You will overtake in the name of Jesus Christ. Today is that day that the anointing is going to set you free from every spiritual limitation from your home, demonic forces from your home. Every stagnation is being broken. I don't know why I hear stagnation. I want you to know that God is on your case. Nyangi Willis, I hear is your season for testimony. Makata lava zende, legede zika yata, makuta lava, lepo soko yanda. As you're watching me, wherever you're watching me from, I want you to hear this. The Lord is telling me that He's turning your life around. The Lord is telling me that He's setting you free. Regardless of what you've been going through, you are throwing in the towel because you thought you are the one that holds your destiny. But today He has sent me. It's too early for you to give up. It's too early for you to quit. In the name of Jesus, I cancel that spirit. The anointing is going to enlighten. When you see the first breath is about light, you are going to, your life will enlighten. The things you've been doing, the dullness, the veil, the stagnation, the garment that they're putting in your life, as it has been broken in the name of Jesus. What do I mean about stagnation? You take two steps ahead. Before you know it, you take six backwards. Today, the anointing of God is going to break that yoke in the name of Jesus Christ. Mandalaba zekeyata, magada zokoyete, ligada zokoyata laba. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 33 that I ask and you will receive your answers. When you pray, God will answer you. I decree and I declare, every stagnation is being broken. anywhere they buried you, the anointing that is coming upon you is going to uncover the grave where they buried you. In the name of Jesus, I release the anointing to make it. I release the anointing to make it. In the name of Jesus. Makayata lava zende legede zikayata magada zekeyata lava hey libada zokoyata. Lord, favor is your portion. Favor is your portion. But the Lord is telling me to tell you, trust Him. Focus on Him. Look up to Him. He'll never put you to shame. Menderebe zikayata lava. Sarah Charles, I hear it's your season for turnaround. That the anointing of God that is coming upon you, you will not die. Susan, you will not die prematurely. Susie, you will not die. Susie, you know you that I'm talking about. The Susie, I hear you will not die premature death. In the name of Jesus Christ, I hear mercy. Yes, Miriam, every yoke is broken. Every spirit of confusion, I silence it in your life in the name of Jesus. I break every yoke of confusion. In the name of Jesus Christ, today you are receiving the anointing. Jacqueline, you shall not go down. Jacqueline Onassis, I hear that tonight, as the anointing of God is coming upon you, you shall do exploit. What you thought it was over, I see God showcasing you. I see God opening doors. I see God showcasing you. Jacqueline, I hear God is restoring the ears and the cacaron. By the reason of the anointing service, your legs have been set free. I see God setting you free financially. I see financially, God is breaking the yoke. Emotionally, I hear emotionally, God is going to showcase you. You've been hurt. There are people you've trusted, but they ended up disappointing you. But first of all, it's healing your emotion to showcase you, so that when you appear before men, your emotions are stable. You are able to operate soberly. In the name of Jesus, Hannah Hawangina, I see it's your season for turnaround. I see it's your season for turnaround. I see your season for turnaround. Lige de zikayata, makatala bazende, leprosokoyata, ligada. Mary, I hear the Lord say, Mary Ben, trust the Lord. I hear, listen to the Lord. Trust Him. He will never put you to shame. Lige de zikayata, makatala bazende, lige de zikayata. Look up to God. Look up to God, Nyamila. I hear you should look up to God. Listen to the Lord. Lige de zikayata lava. He did it on the cross. Liga da zekeyata, makata lava zonda, magada likayata. I see men gathering for your glory, Giovanna. I see men, not just men of great honor, coming to honor you in the name of Jesus, because your season to be honored is now. The grave they covered you, you have been uncovered in the name of Jesus Christ. Anything they breathe and they say nothing good can work, I want to tell you, it's your season for testimony. I see you dancing. I see you celebrating. And out of this anointing service today, as you're listening to me, prepare for a total turnaround. Anytime the Lord wanted to bring good news in a home, there was always a separation. Remember when Jesse was in the house of Jesse, when one of his sons was to be anointed David, the Lord will always orchestrate His own things at His own time and will always break protocol. Today, the anointing service for today is to break protocol. Any pit they dug for you, you are jumping, and after jumping, you're passing. Jump and pass. In the name of Jesus Christ, legeda zikayata lava zonda, makayata lava zende, legeda zoko hata lava zaka, liprosukayata, manda lava zoko yata, legede zikayata lava zonda, liprosukayata lava zonda. Hey, your season for celebration has come. John King, I hear celebration. I hear celebration. The anointing of God breaks stagnation. Listen. When that oil is being crushed, when the fruit is being crushed, the process is awful. The process is never sweet. But see out the outcome of it all. Whatever you've been going through, it has been a hard situation. It has been a hard process. But I'm here to tell you, it's your season for turnaround. In the name of Jesus, legede zikayat makata labazanda legede zikayat alaba lipo sukayat alaba mendele zikayat alaba zende. The anointing of God will cause men to backdate and remember you. Backdate what they were meant to give you and they said they could not do, but because the anointing of the Lord is upon you, every yoke is broken and speed comes in. And the moment speed comes in, you do not need to explain to people what is happening, because when God is working under the grace and the anointing of God upon your life, nobody can take glory, because you yourself, you can only say this can only be God. So as you listen to me tonight, we are breaking every yoke that the Amalekites have been doing in your destiny. Every yoke of stagnation, we break it. Legede zikayata labazonda makata labazeke leprosa kayata labazende legede zikayata laba yes yegede zikayanda liprosoko yata laba legede zikayanda makuta laba leprosuka yanda libada zeke yanda libada zeke yata legede zikayata laba leprosoko yanda. The Lord is saying that whatever he said about you is faithful and is going to do it in the name of Jesus Christ. Liba da zekeyata, libo da zekeyanda laba, meketa laba, lebo da zekeyanda, legeda zokohata, lebo da zakayata, ligede zikayanda. Our nation is being delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. The masses of God is overruling every judgment. The love of God is overruling every judgment in the name of Jesus Christ. Today they must let you go. The Egyptians you saw, you will never see them no more. You will see them no more, because he's sending men, he's causing men to go out of their way. By the reason of the anointing service tonight, stand and celebrate. It's your season for turnaround. When you look at the olive oil, it goes through the olive fruit, it goes through three processes or three steps. First of all is that when the first extraction, or when the first press, we extract a virgin oil. The second one is for healing. The third one is for cleansing. So there are always 3 hours of a human being. So tonight I want you to rise up wherever you are and turn around 3 times and say, it's my season for turnaround. It's my season. Every yoke has been broken. Every yoke is letting me go. Every yoke, I'm no longer a bond servant. You will not live in slavery. You are receiving your freedom. Your business, you will not start a business within 3 months is booming. Before you know it, for the rest of the 9 months or 8 months, nothing seems to be working. Or 6 months is a lie. I break that spirit today. I break that demon today in the name of Jesus. Alaba da zakayata laba lebo do zukayata laba zende lipo sukayata laba prolikreta laba zikayanda mendelebe zikayata laba zende legede zikayata laba makata laba. Every shame, I share this scripture, matter, I share this scripture, Isaiah 54 verses 4. You will forget the shame. You will forget the shame of your youth. You shall not suffer shame. That is what I hear the Lord say. Ligede zika yatalaba, maka yatalaba zonda, leprosoko yatalaba, legede zika yata, leprosoko talaba zende. Jesus was pressed 3 times and he went through a lot, but he did not give up, because by the end of it, there's been a crowning of it. There was a crowning to another dimension. So today I see the Lord doing the same in this anointing service. Every delay is being broken. Nearness to success syndrome is being broken. Rejection is letting you go. Stagnation is being dealt with in this anointing service. In the name of Jesus Christ, no man, no woman shall take your place. Any man, any woman that has said you will never sit on the throne of glory that God has orchestrated for you, they have failed in Jesus' name, because you are jumping, passing and going to elevation in the name of Jesus Christ. Lebo da zekeyata, magada zokoye terebe, liprosukayata. The anointing is coming to break every yoke of death, every yoke of premature death in your home. Yegede zikayanda, every foundation must let you go. Every foundation must let you go. Every evil foundations that were laid. Those are the yokes. The Bible says that they'll do what? They shall be lifted off their shoulder. In other words, they will be lighter. No more burden. God is turning your life around. You are jumping and passing. You must jump and pass. That pit they dug for you. The spirit of premature death is broken in Jesus' name. The places they buried your name. By the reason of this anointing service, I believe you will come and testify. The anointing signified a sanctification, a separation. Anytime the anointing comes upon you, you become a touchnot. That does not mean you will not go through battles. You will go through battles, but the one that called you will defend you. The one that called you will defend you. You will not have mouth to defend yourself, but he will put words of wisdom, words of knowledge that no man will be able to contradict, according to his word in the book of Matthew, in the book of Luke 21:15, that when you speak, it becomes an order. The moment David was anointed, it did not matter whether he came from the bush. The moment it was the season of Joseph, it did not matter who was backing him. God was with him, and the anointing proved men wrong. So today, the anointing, in this our anointing service, as per the Lord led us, you are receiving a total turnaround. He went through three times the process Jesus went through. He positioned himself and he said, I will not give up. And after, there was time to be glorified. Whatever you are going through is coming to an end today. The anointing that is coming upon your head is not just an anointing, but it's a season for turnaround. Legede zika yata laba, liprosuka yata, legede zika yata, leprosoko yata, ligede zika yanda, liprosoko talaba, liproseke yata, legede zika yata, mandalaba zaka yata laba zende, lekro talaba, liprosoko yanda. Men have been saying they don't understand you. Yes, because they look at you with their natural eye. But I want you to know, when the anointing of God comes upon you, you will become more mystery to them. Because when a child of God is loved by God, guarded by God, heavenly protected, heavenly rubber stamped, you become a mystery that no man will understand you. You are a man of many colors. You become a rainbow to many. And to some, they can't even call you a rainbow. They call you a mystery, a wind. So that anointing is coming upon you tonight. Child of God, I want you to know, in this anointing service, every yoke is being broken. You're telling me, woman of God, prophesy over my business. I'm here to tell you, the anointing is breaking every yoke of being rejected. People will place orders. And when it is the time for them to come and do the necessary and pay you, they'll start saying you did a shoddy job. It's a lie of the devil. And now you feel like giving up. You don't want to continue doing that business because you feel like God has left you. It's a lie. God is turning your life around. The anointing today is breaking every yoke. Ha! Legede zika yatalaba, oh nipo yatalaba, leprosuka yatalaba zende, legede zika yata, leboda zaka hatalaba zende, leprosuka yatalaba, legede ziko yanda, makatalaba zende, leprosoko terebe, legede zika yata, mandalaba zoko yata, legede zika yatalaba zonda, makatalaba zaka, leprosoko, you are watching me. You could be a teenager that thinks you're struggling with peer pressure. I want to tell you today, God is delivering you in Jesus' name. You are watching me, you're an orphan. You don't know where the next meal is coming from. I want to tell you something, that after this anointing service, God is sending someone and putting your name in the mouth of your divine destiny helpers. I got a revelation yesterday about this. They are destiny helpers and they are divine destiny helpers. Divine destiny helpers is their full-time responsibility to make sure you've reached to where God told them. Destiny helpers can be there. We thank God for them. But those that are divinely positioned, no matter the matter, it will be their responsibility. So God is sending, after this anointing service, God is sending you divine destiny helpers in the name of Jesus. Lepo saka yatalaba. Mandalaba zeke yata. Legede zika yatalaba zonda, makaya talaba, leprosuka yatalaba zende, ligede zika yatalaba zende, maka talaba zoko yete, leprosuka talaba, leboda zaka yata. You are not going down. Today is our day of breakthrough. Today is our night of transformation. Leprosuka yatalaba, mendele zika yata, libada zoko yata, legede zika yatalaba zonda. Mandalaba zoko yatalaba zende legede zika yatalaba makuta laba yendele bezinda libada zoko hatalaba. Today this anointing will cause men to remember you. Why the anointing? Anytime the Lord wants to do something new, anytime the Lord wants to visit a home, anytime the Lord wants to visit a family, there will always be a separation or a sanctification to say, this is my own. I want to do something new. But sometimes he might not speak about something new. He will just come. He will come and interrupt your program. So today, that is what God is going to do. This anointing will cause a shift in the realm of the spirit that you will not understand what is happening to you. Liba da zeke yatalaba, maka yatalaba zende, lebo da zoko yatalaba zika yanda. I breathe the breath of God. Manalaba zeke yata. Every storm that has been causing you to doubt God, today they must let you go. I command, let the storm stand. Let there be stillness in the name of Jesus. Legede zika yatalaba, makatalaba zende, legede zika yata, mandalaba zoko yatalaba zika, leprosoko talaba, lekutalaba zende, libada zaka yatalaba, leboda zoko yatalaba zende, makayatalaba. It's a new season. I see God changing things. I see hands exchanging for your destiny. In other words, the places you are rejected, the contracts that they took away from you, I see them again coming to exchange hands, whereby you'll have to sign those contracts in the name of Jesus Christ. I silence every yoke of stagnation. After this anointing service, you will come and testify. Your feet are anointed in Jesus' name. After this anointing service, I don't care where you're watching me from. What I know, the grace and the angels of God are moving. The atmosphere is set for your breakthrough. Just change your mentality and receive your breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. Makata lava zonda. Legede zika yata. Manda lava zoko yeterebe zika yata. Makuta lava. Lebro zoko yata lava. Le Susie. Every yoke of premature death is broken in your life. Susie, I saw God breaking the yoke of premature death. You will not die premature death. I cancel that spirit. I cancel that canopy of premature death. And I breathe the breath of God over your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mandalaba zeke yatalaba. Liposuka yatalaba. Lebrozuka yandalaba zende. Liprasika talaba. When the anointing of God upon you, when the anointing of God is upon you, you become a war zone to many. But one thing, you are sure of winning. Why do I say war zone? When you are anointed, the anointing of God will cause you to be, it becomes attractive. You become attractive, either with good or bad. But anytime there's a bad in what way? Accusations will come. But what happens? The Lord turns tables around for your good. That is what God is going to do. The anointing will set you free from every bondage, every sickness that has been breathing in your life. Today, they are letting you go. Every arrow of rejection, when you're just about to receive it, you become the point of contact, the point of discussion to your destiny helpers. What discussion? The moment the anointing comes upon you, they start thinking, oh, what can we do to the person? What can we do? Where is she? Where is he? How is the business doing? They start looking for you because that garment has left you. That garment of rejection has left you. The moment he died on the cross, the curtain was torn into two and he said, it's finished. And the moment he said it was finished, the Spirit of God came upon us, and before you know it, came upon the disciples, and they would speak in tongues that nobody would understand. In other words, there was elevation. So when the anointing of God comes upon you tonight, there shall be elevation. Jesus had to be crushed, had to be pressed. And when he was being pressed, for 30 years he was being pressed. But within 3 years when he began his ministry, there was a great impact that nobody would be able to explain. An imaginable change, an imaginable move, signs and wonders that nobody will take glory. What am I trying to tell you? Out of this anointing service, the kind of speed that God is going to release. Remember that this is our month of overtaking, overruling, and overturning. I want you to understand one simple thing, that after this anointing service, the kind of speed that will come upon you, you'll not be able to understand you as a person.
Legele zika yata laba zonda, makuta laba zeketa laba zende, leprosoko yata laba, ligede zika yata laba. I call for your destiny helper.
In this anointing service, I'm calling for not just destiny helpers, divine destiny helpers, that their voice will be inclined to the voice of God. Regardless of what happens, their voice will be in tune to the voice of God, because they will be divinely sent for an assignment. So the moment they know that we are on assignment, they will be focused to the one that called them to be of your help, to hold your hands. So tonight, after this anointing service, prepare to receive your God divinely sent destiny helpers. In the name of Jesus.
Leba de zika yatalaba zoko yanda liprosuka talaba liprosuka talaba lebrosoko talaba.
Everything he went through, everything that Jesus went through, the pressing that he went through, just the same way the olive fruit goes through, for it to bring out the sweetness, the impotence, the sacred practice behind anointing oil, was done after he died on the cross. So I want you to understand one thing. It's not about who is with you and who is not, but it's about the God that we are serving, and the God that has anointed you. The same God that raised Isaac, the same God that fought for Abraham, the same God that rewrote the story of Abraham, the same God that rewrote the story of Joseph, the same God that rewrote the story of David, the same God that rewrote the story of Elizabeth. When it was all said and done, that same God came and blessed Elizabeth. When men, we can say men of full stop, which is menopause, but according to God, it's just another new day. Watch and see what God will do after this anointing service. Those that have been termed barren, there's going to be fruitfulness in your home, fruitfulness in your marriage, fruitfulness in your business. The anointing of God is breaking every yoke of stagnation.
Lebo da zeke ya talaba zende. Minda laba zeke ya talaba zende. Ligede zika ya talaba. When God says it's, when men says it is done, God still says it is still not yet done, my daughter. It's still not yet done, my son. I am here to do mysteries in your life. I am here to take you far. I am here to rewrite your story. What men thought that they had it in your hands, they had it in their hands. God comes and turns the tables around. Tonight, what your family has been going through, the Amalekites that have enslaved you, tonight is that night of deliverance. Let the anointing of God break that yoke. Let the anointing of God turn your tables around. Let the anointing of God uplift you. Let the anointing of God break that yoke of nearness to success syndrome. Let the breaking, the anointing of God break every barrenness. Let the anointing of God break every soul tie in your life, in the name of Jesus. Let the anointing of God disconnect you from every marine spirit, marine forces from the lake that fight you. Tonight, they will let you go. What has stolen you, whatever took your star through the dream, they cannot take it. They can only dim it. So whatever they took and they did to your star, that you cannot shine. From today, as the way the stars gather to stop the sun, and they are defeated, so shall it be in your life. No matter the gathering of or the numbers of stars gathering against the sun, they cannot stop the rays of the sun to appear. That is what your destiny will be.
After this anointing oil or this anointing service, you are going to see what God is going to do in your life. I want you to believe it. Don't tell me you're far. Distance is not a barrier. Believe and see God's fighting for you.
Lebede zika yatalaba zonda. Maka yatalaba. Leprosuka yatalaba. The places you are rejected. Ah, libo da zeke yata. Lige de zika yatalaba. Lege de zika yata. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 7, the stone the builders rejected has now become or is now the chief cornerstone. What does it mean? This anointing oil will make you a chief cornerstone, a point of attraction, a point of, you will become a foundation, not just a building material. Liprosuka yatalaba, a foundation. The places you've been rejected, God is setting you to be a stone that can never, you are that stone, but tonight you are becoming the chief cornerstone, a stone that cannot be ignored. God is causing you tonight to release impact in your destiny. I breathe life in your destiny. In the name of Jesus, I breathe life in our nation. And I speak peace and mercy. No bloodshed in Jesus' name. I release the grace of God. As our lives have been anointed and our lives have been turned around, every yoke is being broken. As they are being broken and being crushed down, so shall our destiny go up. And anything that is not right in our nation, Father God, have mercy and put things into place. Let the angels in charge of mercy overrule every judgment. If anyone has been found or has been put in any bondage because of ignorance, let your mercy overrule every judgment. Let your mercy hold the hands of your children. The Bible says in the book of Job, chapter 5, verse 12, for the Lord frustrates the plans of the wicked. Some scripture says he thwarts the plans of the wicked. Let the anointing of God tonight thwart every plan of the wicked against your destiny. In the name of Jesus. May God frustrate the plans of the wicked. May the broom of destruction sweep away every barrier that has been standing between you. Any pillar, barrier represents a pillar that comes between you and your God, divinely ordained destiny helpers. Tonight, the barrier has been broken. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are possessing your possession. That word you have won it. Joshua was told by the Lord to go and do what? In the wall of Jericho. To go around. And as they went round, they seemed as if nothing was happening. But by the end of the day, they conquered. Therefore, any man, any woman that has been standing against you, between you and your destiny helper, by the reason of the anointing of God that is coming upon your home, that is coming upon your health, in Jesus' mighty name, receive your deliverance. This anointing will set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. Legede zika yata laba, manda laba zeke yata laba zonda. Legede zika yata, makuta laba zeke yata laba zonda. Leprosuka yata laba, legede zika yata, manda laba zoko yetelebe. Hey, the places they rejected you, they did not know that you are the next owner, that you're coming to own that place. Forgive them. Rise up, shake off the dust. Rejoice because it is your season to testify. You are saying, people are saying you're proud. That process, maybe yes you are, but you have to go through that process so that when God blesses you, you will only say it's by the grace of God. Fear not. Do not feel as if God has left you. Today, by the reason of this anointing service, you are receiving your deliverance in Jesus' name. I am here to charge you. That Amalekai that has been sitting on you, that has been feeding you wrong information about your destiny, they must let you go tonight. Mandala bazoko ya talabazoka. Hey, libada zoko talabazoka. Libada zeke yanda. Every tongue that is not of God, anything, any tongue that is speaking against the word of God, I cancel. Anything that is standing against you and your breakthrough, I am here to tell you I cancel. I break every
every yoke of stagnation. Legede zika yata laba, makata laba zonda, legede zika yata, leboda zoko yanda laba, leprosuka yata laba, magada zoko yete, ligede zika yanda laba zonda, makata laba zende, legede zika yata, leprosoko yete, liprosuka talaba. Hey, when he died, he became the righteousness of Christ. And the Bible says in the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 1 and verses 9, you have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God your God has set you by the anointing, you with your oil of joy in the name of Jesus. He says, therefore, God your God has set you above your companions by the anointing. This anointing, when it comes upon you, tonight the Lord will set you high. There will be speed above your companion in the name of Jesus. There will be speed. You will not be on the ground, you'll be on the top. It will push you. The anointing of God will catapult you from the back seat to the front seat in the name of Jesus. Makaya talaba zonda liprosuka yatalaba. Oh, libada zeke yanda. You will not suffer shame. You will not suffer shame. Every shame they have gathered against you, I cancel. In the name of Jesus Christ. Libada zeke yatalaba zonda. Libada zeke yatalaba zonda. Lege de zika yanda. As this day ends and we break into a new day, I share is your season for testimony. Tonight you will testify in the name of Jesus Christ. Any pit they dug and they wanted you to enter, you are passing through. I still hear, jump and pass. You are jumping and passing that place. Ah, libo da zeke yata. Liga da zeke yanda. They are Malachi's you, so you will see them no more. The Egyptians that have been withholding the Lord's blessing from you with a spirit of delay, today they must let you go. The anointing to make it, the anointing to overtake, the anointing to overturn, the anointing to overrule is upon your head. The anointing to overturn and overturn three times is upon your head. The anointing to overtake and overtake and overtake is coming upon you and already in your life in Jesus' name. By the reason of you just listening, as you are in this service, why do I say that? He says in Matthew 18:18, where two or three are gathered in my name, as we are gathered together in the name of the Lord, whatsoever we shall agree, it shall come to pass. And above all, that is not the only thing. He says, whatever we shall bound on earth, it shall be bound in heaven. Therefore, I decree and I declare, wherever you are and whatever situation you've been through, I decree and I declare, the anointing of God is coming over your head and is breaking every yoke in the name of Jesus. Hey, liba da 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 da. Liposuka yata lava zende. It is your season. It is your month for new revelation, new dimension. Ministerially, God is taking you far. In the name of Jesus, your relationship with God is going to a higher note. You will not struggle to pray. God is sending men that will cause you to stand. In the name of Jesus, these men will come in and they will come like they are angels, but will come in the form of men. Prepare for them. Be wise in Jesus' name. Legede, some of you are receiving wisdom. The Bible says Jesus grew in stature and he had wisdom. He grew in stature. Wisdom with man. Jesus grew in wisdom, his stature. And he has favor with man. He had favor with man and with God. Some of you, this anointing will give you wisdom. We release the anointing of wisdom that when you speak, people will not be able to understand. Some of you are growing in stature. Your physique, God is helping you that you'll be able to present yourself before your destiny helpers. Some of you, God is releasing the anointing of favor before God and before man. So anytime you speak, nobody will be able to contradict what you speak. Some of you, you are receiving the wisdom to be wiser than your family members, because God has chosen you to be the one that is leading your family. So you must be wise and receive wisdom from God on how to lead in the name of Jesus Christ. Shatalaba zende yanda liprosuka yatalaba. Liga da zeke yandalaba. Maka yatalaba zondalaba. Leprosuka yatalaba. This anointing will showcase you before men. The anointing of God will represent you before your destiny helpers. And some, the anointing of God will cause your enemies to be a footstool, according to his word. The book of Hebrews 1:13. He said, sit until I make your enemies to be your footstool. After this prayer, you will not just see this. There are people that wronged you. Some will look for you to apologize. And they will not come empty-handed. Those are called the wise men. When they realize what has happened, they'll come back and look for you and do the will of God. In the name of Jesus, some of you, God is going to relocate you from where you're living to another dimension, because it is your season to venture into God-ordained, orchestrated testimony that no man will take glory but God himself. Some of you, God will shake you to make you. We just read and we understood about the olive fruit. What did God do? Sorry, before it becomes an olive oil, it has to be crushed. Jesus also was pressed down. So some of you, you've been going through this. After the anointing of God, God will bring order in your homes. And the way he will do it, you will not understand. But only him. What you need to do is submit. When you read the scripture in the book of Isaiah chapter 1 and you come to verses 14, what does it say? If my people are willing and obedient, they will eat the fruit of the land. Every prophetic word, there's always an instruction. Even after this service, the Lord will instruct you. My daughter, my son, now that you are delivered from every yoke of slavery, I want you to walk this way. I want you to change on this character. I want you to drop this. So do not carry anything that will be a baggage again after your deliverance. Maintain what God is going to do. Leave that which you used to do that did not please the Lord. Because I know what God is going to do. Child of God, is because time. We do not have time to give you the testimonies we've been receiving. The testimony that we receive phone calls. There are those who got their job just while watching here. There are those who have been relocated. There are people that even right now, yesterday or the other, they went for interviews just through following here. So it's because we don't have that time. So I want you to know, and I want you to understand, and have faith. Don't look at me as Liz. Don't look at me as Prophetess Elizabeth. Look at me as that servant that God has ordained for your destiny. God will not come from heaven and do what he wants to do in your life. He will put his power and authority over a man. And the man might not look like it. Just like this anointing service, it may not look like the normal anointing service that you know, or maybe how servants of God you've ever watched or listened what they do. For every man that God calls, God gives them specific assignments. So like tonight, God is telling me, I don't know why, he's telling me to tell you this. Maintain and be careful. As you receive what God is going to do, as you've gotten it in prayer, maintain prayer. Every yoke is being broken. Stagnation is going. All I hear tonight is a night of breaking every stagnation. Every barrenness. The Amalekites you saw, you will see them no more. But maintain your relationship with God. Wherever you are, I want you to get the anointing oil. Shatalaba. Liba da zeke yanda. Have faith, have faith, have faith. Have faith and trust God. Lege de zika yata. Libo da zeke yatalaba zonda. Liba da zeke yatalaba. Mindalaba zeke, I want you to get your anointing oil. I'm giving you time. Liprosuka yatalaba. Mandalaba zeke yata. Thank you, O God. The Bible says in 68 of Psalms 20, our God is a God who saves. From the sovereign Lord comes escape from death. The anointing of God that is coming upon you is removing you and causing you to escape every plot of death. Death could not just be physical, but your business, barrenness, God is causing you to escape it. There will be an escape. Tonight is your night of escape after this anointing service. Not only will you escape, you are recovering all. Not only are you recovering all, any pit they dug, you are jumping and passing. And above all, God is going to expose. And after exposing, he's going to dispose people that are not genuine in your destiny. The mistakes you've been doing over and over, today they come to an end. The mistakes you've been embracing, thinking that you're embracing the right thing, today God is exposing them. And after exposure, is disposing them. There are people, when they leave you, speed will come. So what God wants to do, prepare. The process is never sweet. But child of God, do you prefer going through the same situation, embracing the same character, just because it gives you little pleasure, and before you know it, you're stagnating all through? As God is setting you free, causing you to escape from death, you too, make up your mind, focus. Shake off the mistakes you did, because God is a God of mercy, and move on. The Bible says in 68 of Psalms 20, God is a God who saves. And child of God, I want to tell you, not only does he save, he also causes you to escape from death. So anything, if it is your character that has been causing you to dwell on that mountain, today you are standing on Mount Zion and you must receive your deliverance. The Mount Zion is the anointing service here today, and we are gathered in this page for our deliverance. I am receiving my deliverance as I stand here, as I sit here, as I speak in your life. In the spiritual realm, I'm receiving my deliverance. Any baggage that I've been carrying along in my life that is not of God, that can cause me not to minister as a servant of God, God is releasing it from my life. So everybody here, you've got an appointment with your destiny. So the moment you know you are having an appointment with your destiny, do not focus on where or who is listening to you. Focus on the deliverance you are receiving from now by the reason of the anointing that is coming upon your head. In the name of Jesus, I want you to have faith. I want you to trust the Lord. And I want you to look up to the Lord. He's a faithful God. He told me, I have anointed you to proclaim, to set the captive free. Go and set them free. Go and take back what the enemy took from them. Because God cannot come from heaven. He will put his supernatural anointing or power over a man, and that man become a mystery. And he has given him authority to trample upon snakes and scorpions. And while you listen and you follow the man, the power is being exchanged from the man and comes upon you through impartation or even through listening. That's why sometimes what you listen matters a lot. So right now, stop listening to the devil telling you that, oh, she's far. No! Do not lose your focus. This is your hour. Receive your own revelation and you'll see what God will do. Handalaba zeke yata. Lige de zika yandalaba. Maka yata laba zonda. Lipro suka yata. With the anointing oil that you poured in your hand, the Bible says, and in that day, their burden will be lifted from off their shoulder or off your shoulder. Their yoke from your neck. And the yoke will be broken because of their grown fat. And when you come to the book of Hebrews that we were just reading, Hebrews chapter 1 and verses 9, the scripture says, you have loved righteousness and you have hated what? You have hated wickedness. Therefore, your God has set you above your companion by the anointing, or by anointing you with the oil of joy. I decree and I declare, take the anointing oil, place it on your forehead. I decree and I declare from today, as I stretch forth my hands, wherever you are, just trust God. Here is a matter of faith and trusting God. He sent me tonight in your home, in that hospital bed, far away, distance, because in him, he knows distance is not a barrier, but he has allowed that distance for you to see how big he is. The scripture says he uses the foolish things of this world. He has said, by anointing you. So tonight in this anointing service, God is anointing you. He says, you have loved righteousness. Who is that? Jesus is the righteousness of Christ. When the scripture says you have loved righteousness, you've loved walking in the ways of God. And what else? And you have hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has set you above your companions. What has been a problem? Whatever you've been struggling with, today you are receiving your deliverance. God is setting you above, beyond your contemporaries. You will be an ego that no man will understand. This anointing, as you place it on your head, from today it ceases to be oil, but the anointing, an instrument of war in your life. The anointing is breaking every yoke of stagnation. This anointing oil is breaking every yoke of backwardness, every yoke of nearness to success syndrome, every barrenness that has been operating in your life today. Receive the healing of God. Our nation, no more dryness. I speak peace over the government. I speak mercy. Lord, people might be seeing and thinking all is well, but you who see beyond, I plead mercy for our nation. Let this anointing, as your daughter, Lord, as I pray for your children, let this anointing spread out to our nation. Lord, I plead for mercy. As your children, where we've gone wrong, Daddy, let your mercy prevail. Lord, let this anointing, there are people that have put themselves in problem because of ignorance. Lord, I plead for mercy. Through this anointing service, every Amalekite that has been ruling their lives, today they let them go in Jesus' name. With the anointing of God over my life, I release it over your children. You that does not console men before you use a man, please, Lord, do that which no man can do in their life. Tonight, oh God, set their lives free. There are people that are watching me, their dream lives have been stolen by the kingdom of darkness. Restore. There are people that are watching me and their finances is in bondage. Restore. By the reason of this anointing, break every yoke. Lord, let there be a testimony. Lord, we've had testimonies through this page because of what you are doing. As we've heard and celebrated the rest, and others that are watching me are trusting you for testimonies. Daddy, do it. Let there be let this anointing of God be made manifest. Lord, I stretch forth my hands. Let your power take charge. Let your anointing, that those that are watching me, they are peaceless. But the Bible says, the God of peace, meaning he's a God that gives peace. And in his way of operation, to some that are causing us to be peaceless, you exchange, you deal with them, and you give us peace. Lord, tonight, I want to receive testimonies. I thank you because I know you are listening to us. The Bible says some trust in chariots in Psalms 91, and some trust in horses, chapter 10, Isaiah chapter 10. But we will trust in the Lord. Lord, tonight we are trusting in you. Do that which no man can do. Lord, turn the lives of your children around. The Bible says in the book of Joel chapter 2, and verses 25, you say that you will do restoration the years that the cacawam and farming workers. That is delay. You are breaking every delay in Jesus' name. Every serpentine, Leviathan spirit that controls the children of God, today let them go. The children of God that are struggling even to pray, that they cannot pray because the kingdom of darkness has invaded their homes. Lord, let there be deliverance by the reason of this. Those are the yokes we are talking about. Lord, break it. There's nothing you cannot do. I've seen you fighting for battles for me. Fight for your children. There are people that are watching me. They're at the verge of giving up. Today, strengthen them in Jesus' name. Lord, restore their homes. Lord, restore their lives. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, are not angels our ministering angels? Our ministering spirits. Sent to serve those who will inherit the kingdom of God. From today, I release the angels of God that will guard them. Out of this anointing service, let them experience the sweetness of moving with angels. Your word says in the book of Hebrews chapter 1:14, are not angels ministering spirits? And the scripture says we are the candlelight of God. Our spirit are candlelights. So together with the angels of God, I release total deliverance. I break every yoke of stagnation. I break it once again. Like you remember the man in the pool of Bethsaida in John chapter 5. Remember your children. Some have stayed on that pool for 20 years, for 30 years, that they have been known by the society. Nothing good can come out of them. Out of this anointing service, deliver families. Deliver homes, oh God. Lord, I thank you for what you are doing and what you are going to do. That anointing oil on their heads, from today they become a touch not. That anointing oil on their head, they become elevated in the name of Jesus. By the reason of the anointing, every veil that has been covering them and garment of darkness, lose them in Jesus' name. The three things that Jesus did on the cross, he was set free and delivered from every power of darkness. And the agony went through the pain. And above all, Jehovah, you forgave him. That is the anointing. That is what the anointing is going to do. As the process that happens in the olive oil to be crushed, the process, the extraction of virgin oil, of healing, the anointing of healing, and above all of cleansing, so is you cleansing their homes, cleansing their marriages, cleansing their businesses, cleansing their background, cleansing their thinking, cleansing their relationship between you and them, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you because we are receiving testimonies. I know there's someone watching me, oh God, and they do not understand what is happening. By the reason of this anointing service, every yoke is broken. And it's their season to testify. In the name of Jesus. 9 is a month of delivery. Lord, I thank you because right now, that is what is going to happen to them. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for testimony. Above all, I want to say thank you for your faithfulness over this page. Thank you, O Lord. We give you the praise for every viewer. Holy Spirit, manifest in their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Maybe you're here, you're watching me. You may not be understanding what is happening. And even when I talk about what Jesus did on the cross, you might be having a knowledge about what he did, but you're not part and parcel of it. And today, this could be a great opportunity for you and me to join the heavens to celebrate him. Maybe you're saying you are a sinner. You do not even deserve to stand before God. But do you know what the Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 8 and verses 35? It says there is nothing that can separate us from the love of Christ. When he says he loves you, he loves you. We sin. We were born with a sin nature, but as we chose to confess Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior of our lives, I take this opportunity to welcome you into the kingdom of God, the kingdom of our Abba Father, the God that has never failed us. Give your life to Christ for you to enjoy and have a relationship with God. Maybe you're saying, how will I manage? We start first by giving your life to Christ. Then after that, we move together with you. And you will enjoy. That does not mean challenges will not be there. They will be there. But you'll be a different person in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is in need of you. He wants to use you. You see, maybe you're saying you're deep in sin in downhill. And you feel as if nobody will remember you. Even the prodigal son said, I'd rather go back. Some of you are born again. But because of what you are going through during COVID-19, you've decided to give away, to to say God is not there, and you decide to give up what you say backsliding. I'm here to tell you God is in need of you. That's your testimony. Someone needs to hear it. Someone needs to hear that you also tried to be born again and you failed, but now you are able to stand and you are preaching the word of God. You are the next great evangelist that you are having in this nation and outside this nation. I will not be proud, I will not be embarrassed to tell you, give your life to Christ. I want you to repeat after me. Say, dear Lord Jesus, if you are not born again and you are willing to give your life to Christ, I want to say, dear Lord Jesus, I come before you. I accept that I'm a sinner. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I'm born again. I confess that you died on the cross. You came and you died on the cross for my sin. And from today, I give my life to you. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I am born again. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Let me pray for you. I decree and I declare, Lord, that as they have given their life to Christ, they will stand the test of time. Today being our anointing service, you are anointing them. Double in Jesus' name. Thank you, oh God. Give them the strength and the grace to stand the test of time. In the name of Jesus Christ. Walk with them through the process in Jesus' name. Send men that are your God kind, that will walk with them, that will move with them wherever they are, oh God. Father, I thank you because the angels in heaven are celebrating. That is why we are this service for them. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I know I'm far from where you're watching me, or maybe I'm inside. I'm not that very far from where you are. After the service, details will continue running, so you'll get to know more about us in Jesus' mighty name. Congratulations for giving your life to Christ. And above all, I want to congratulate everybody that tuned in. Your life is never going to remain the same in the name of Jesus Christ. You're here to be celebrated. People will be shocked. People will not understand what is going to happen to you. And that as they are shocked, remember not to take the glory. Let the glory go back to God. I've seen God turning things around, and I've seen what the power of the anointing of God can do. Please live holy, live for God. Carry nobody in your heart. Look up to God, the author and the finisher of your faith. Thank you so much. This anointing service will be an anointing service to be remembered. Remember you have jumped and passed. Remember the Lord has released a way of escape. Remember your life has turned around. Every yoke is broken and every burden has been lifted. Go and celebrate because you love God. And not only do you love God, you hate wickedness. Above all, your own God. Yes, your own God has set you and will set you upon your higher above your contemporaries because of the anointing. You are a spirit man. I charge you to go and make it. Until we meet next time on Wednesday, God bless you so much. Thank you for joining in. Once again, my name is our prophetess, Elizabeth Omolo. I'm so excited. Thank you so much. God bless you. Thank you for tuning in. See you next week on Tuesday. Very soon, we'll let you know a lot how things are, we'll be operating, and wherever we are. God bless you once again. Thank you. I love you all, and thank you for tuning in. This month is a month for you to remember. Everything will make sense by the end of this month to you because of what God will have done. God bless you. Yes, Lord. Liga da zoko yata labazanda. Leprosuka yata labazanda. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for what you're doing. Lebo da zeke yata labazanda.